Conclave East, former Railways Minister, senior Bengal political figure, joining us at the India Today Conclave. Can we have a round of applause as we welcome Mr. Dinesh Trivedi?
My big hello to Calcutta, the city of joy, and I wish I was there physically. But as situation would have it, I'm there emotionally with all of you. And I think, Rahul, you know, it's just a coincidence. It reminds me of the day when I had resigned as the railway minister. And Mr. Puri, if he's sitting there, he would remember, I was not slated for the India Today Conclave, which used to happen in Delhi only. And then they grabbed me and say that, you know, I was having lunch with Henry Kissinger. So he said, no, you have to come. We have to have a special slot. And here I am today, India Today Conclave and another resignation. So I think India Today has some special relationship with me. So Mr. Puri, Rahul, thank you very much for having me there.
You do have a flair for the dramatic. We love having you. But what's with these dramatic resignations? I remember interviewing you when you were railway minister. You know, you had tears in your eyes after the budget when you'd increased the rail prices. And now again, you know, what is with Dinesh Trivedi and dramatic unexpected resignations?
No, Rahul, I am very emotional and very sensitive. And I think that is the minimum a human being has, no? And there is nothing dramatic as such. It was happening, you know. Jisko kehte hai na, manthan chal rahe hai mere system. Aur sirf mujhe nahi, sabko pata hai ki kuch ho raha hai. And then there comes a moment, which I said, I don't know how many of you could hear that. Jo karta hun, wo dil se karta hun. Wo antakaran mein jo aata hai, wo ek moment hota hai. Aur wo moment tabhi aata hai, jab iske pehle manthan hua ho. So it was not anything pre-planned, it just happened. But before it happened, there were a lot of manthan and a lot of things, because you understand, the party which I personally was instrumental, a part of it with the leader. And if I have to leave that party, there are emotional involved and there has to be some very substantial good reason. And whatever I said on the floor of the house, that is it. There is nothing less, there is nothing more.
So you've been on the political fence, as it were, for quite some time, not just weeks, months, but actually years. Why is it, Dinesh Trivedi, that you've decided to take the political plunge and leave the party which you say gave you so much and you've been so close to?
Yes, so what's the question, Rahul?
Why did you leave the Trinamool Congress?
No, I told you exactly. See, what happens that if you are part of a party, you have to be in that frame of discipline. And I'm quite a disciplined person. And when you see so much of violence happening, the showmans of, I mean, I couldn't deal with corruption. Every day somebody or the other would come, ki mere ghar mein rang ho raha hai aur aapke log aa gaye paise maange. Ye mujhe se nahi saha jaa. And every day if I go to parliament and give a speech, and the speech could be very critical of some of the policies, but some of the insecure leader will insist that I abuse the prime minister, I abuse the home minister. I said, why should we do that? Bengal culture is not of abuse. Bengal culture is not of violence. And I just couldn't take it. Then there comes a time. So every time, aray, Dinesh Trivedi did not abuse the prime minister of India. Dinesh Trivedi didn't abuse the home minister, Amit Shah. I mean, why should we abuse? Please understand, if we talk about Rabindranath Tagore, if we talk about Mahatma Gandhi and Netaji, why should we abuse Vivekananda? That is the land. There is no place for violence. There is no place for any kind of abuse. Do you know when Mr. Nadda's car was attacked? In one of the television interviews, I condemned. And I was condemned for condemning violence. I mean, how long can you take that? And then I said that Bengal needs to get into 21st century, 22nd century. And Bengalis all, I mean, I consider myself as Bengali. They are full of brain. They are peace-loving. They are philosophers. And if there is any place in the world after Silicon Valley, it can really happen, not only for the namesake, but really. Because that's the brain. And why should Why should this brain go somewhere else? I think Bengal needs to really find its own strength. And believe me, it will find. How it will find, I don't know, but it will find, because enough is enough and people have realized. I will tell you lastly, there's something called peace and prosperity. If there is no peace, there is no prosperity. So we need peace in Bengal. And that is what I was getting a little frustrated. I'm sitting here as a member of parliament and I can't do anything about this violence.
So you've always told me that you felt suffocated and unable to speak your mind. You've now unshackled yourself. So what does an unshackled Dinesh Trivedi have to say about the state of politics and governance in West Bengal? If you were to now dispassionately do a SWOT analysis of the dispensation you've been a part of, Mr. Trivedi, where is it that you believe that the Trinamool Congress government has let down the people of West Bengal and failed to deliver the Paribartan it promised?
You see, first of all, let me tell you one thing, that I have been grateful to the party. There is no doubt about it that I was the founder with Mukul Roy. We both used to run, and Mamtaji used to say that I have got these two people. But that was before we got the power. After we came to power, that conversation was just not there. I mean, you couldn't go and talk about the country, about the progress of Bengal, nothing. And where do you go? And then there are some insecure people who cannot differentiate between a panchayat and a municipality. I mean, they come and take the leadership and you have to listen to them, who have no idea about what's happening. And you have to listen, that you have to abuse them, you have to abuse that. The party has really suffered because of the sycophants. Otherwise, I can tell you, Mamtaji single-handedly, there were no corporate advisors. There were no professional who takes money and advises you. Mamta Banerjee didn't need anybody. She had the pulse of the people. That was the Parivartan. And she said, Bodla nahi bodol chai. Means we do not want revenge. We want change. But then that change got into all sorts of violence, all sorts of corruption. Rahul, every day, if somebody or the other comes to me as a member of parliament that I am painting my house, people have come and asked for money. So I used to say, maybe they are not from TMC, but they are using the TMC. Nothing, no law, no order. I couldn't go anywhere. So I said, where do I go? What do I do? And if people say that if you can't do anything, what is the point of sitting in that August house? And that was going on in my mind. As in the railway ministry, when I resigned, I said, you know, for me, country is much bigger. And that also happened. And believe me, if that money would have come to Bengal, what I had budgeted for Bengal, you could have had so much metro rail all the way up to Barrackpur. Barrackpur would have been a mini Kolkata. I mean, there was so much of development. If you do not have water in the tank, you can't get it in the tap. So all this kind of was a pent-up feeling. And why? Because without even reading the budget, this insecure people would send message to Mamata Banerjee, oh my God, the fares have gone up. This is not it. You know, I'll tell you a story. You have time to listen to this incident?
You are the man of the moment, the biggest newsmaker of the day. We have all the time in the world for you. Go on, Mr. Trivedi.
So, Rahul, first of all, I really feel very sad and relieved both. So after I resigned as the railway minister, I was waiting for a flight at Calcutta. So one gentleman comes to me and said, sir, may I talk to you? I said, sure. He said, I am Professor so-and-so from IIT Kharagpur. I said, you okay? And he said that, do you know Kasab? I said, we don't know Kasab, but we know about Kasab. He was a terrorist. He said, but then he got a chance. He was in jail, there was a trial, and he was asked the process. I said, that's democracy. And then he said, what about Nathuram Godse? Then I thought that what's wrong with this guy? And I said, what about Nathuram Godse? He said, he also got a chance to explain himself. I said, that is democracy. He said, what democracy? you did something good for the country, you resigned, and nobody asked you that, why did you do this? Why did you increase the fare? There was no chance. You were not even given a chance to explain yourself. And then he gave me his card and said, if this is democracy, I don't want this democracy. I could see the frustration on this professor. And then I said, amazing. So this is what the love of the people, that everybody understands what your motives are. And I have always been emotional about the country. And I've always said country come, and it's not just a phrase, which is a fact. That's how my gurus, my parents, when I got the award for the best parliamentarian, I said, because they have put value in me. Now, every day, do you tell me, Rahul, you can differ with a political party, but is it necessary to abuse them? Is it necessary to go below any level of dignity? No party is perfect.
So now, multiple times, Dinesh, you've spoken of these insecure sycophants who kept messaging Didi and drove you out of the Trinamool Congress, those who are your parliamentary party leaders. Now, just as a journalist, if I do some deductions, you're in the Rajya Sabha. Your parliamentary party leader in the Rajya Sabha is Derek O'Brien. So if I ask you to name names, so who are these insecure sycophants you're referring to again and again, who you believe are responsible for driving you out of the Trinamool Congress? Let's get specific.
It is not befitting on my part. And I would be totally out of context if I say that it's only for them. It is not them, it is the leadership. I can go and keep on, anybody keep on telling Mr. Puri that how Rahul is behaving. But Mr. Puri is intelligent, will tell Rahul that what's happening. Will not believe people just like that. I have no complaint about these insecure people. But what about the leadership? You have formed the party. You're part of it. You're part of the struggle. And there is no communication. If you want to talk on a budget, and there has to be a communication. Okay, what point we should take? Should we take farmers' agitation? Okay, 10 of us, let's sit down. What are the points? What should we discuss? Is farmers' agitation right or wrong? If it is wrong, can we go to the Prime Minister and tell him that this is what we want? But that's democracy. Democracy is not abuses all the time. No. And you don't have to go to the well of the house and tear up things. I have never gone to the well of house since 1990. I am an MP. In between, there was a gap. And there is a complaint that Dinesh Trivedi doesn't go to the well of the house. He doesn't scream. He doesn't shout. Now, you don't need to do that. You don't need... That is not Bengal. Please understand, that's not Bengal.
No,
relationship has to be of colleagues. It is not 9-to-5 job that there is some boss and you are subordinate. No. Politics is all about being a teamwork, colleagues, talk to each other. We may be wrong, we may be right. Listen to us, then you decide. Ye nahi hai na, usme dukh hota hai, aur kuch nahi. So, otherwise, Panaj is a great leader. I have no complaint personally, but I feel sorry that the party has really gone out of her hand. And you don't require a professional guy who's paid hundreds of crores to tell you what you should do. I mean, no, you can't be replaced. Mamata Banerjee can't be replaced by somebody. And then if that somebody becomes the owner of the party, then I think it's a sad affair. And we have not come to TMC or form TMC seeing somebody else. It was with Mamata Banerjee. And people in my party will not speak. But whatever I am telling, they'll agree with you. When I was today outside the parliament in front of TV camera, I wouldn't like to name that MP. A sitting MP of TMC goes and gives me thumbs up. He said, well done. I mean, I think introspection is required, no? Because this election will come, go, somebody will win, somebody will lose. That's not the end of life. Be constructive.
So I was speaking, we had Mamata Banerjee, the Chief Minister of West Bengal at the India Today Conclave yesterday. And I spoke to her, I spoke to other senior Trinamool leaders who've been here at the conclave. And the sense that I got was that the TMC believes that Dinesh Trivedi is ungrateful. That you lost your Lok Sabha election in Barrackpore, that despite that you were nominated by Didi to the Rajya Sabha, and despite that right ahead of the elections, instead of supporting the party when it needs you the most, the party that gave you as much as it did, Dinesh Trivedi, you are accused by the Trinamool Congress of backstabbing them.
Well, I'm on the contrary, I've given them the leeway that they can choose whoever they want to choose. So, as a matter of fact, I have taken a bold decision that I have given them total ground free. Now they can choose anybody else they want. You know, and I've got 5.5 years left. If I would have done this thing after the election results, and if supposing if TMC had lost and I had decided this, then somebody would have said, you are an opportunist. I have not done purposely then. Because I knew that this during this election, what do I talk? There's nothing I could talk. So it's better I leave. When I must tell you, when Narada happened, I had told the party that those who are tainted, please keep them away. But they didn't believe. They said, no, it was not done. Then they said the money came from Dubai. I said, both the things can't happen. I said, accept it and let party don't take the blame. Let the individual take it on. And if they have done something wrong, they must face it. They must accept it why they have taken this. I became a bad guy. In 2016, Mamata Banerjee herself said that Dinesh Trivedi will not campaign. I said the right thing against corruption, against violence. It's not the first time. I have been at it. But when I realized that we have reached the end of the tunnel, and end of the tunnel, there is another tunnel. There is no light. What do? You sit in the house, enjoy a big bungalow in Delhi at taxpayers' money. That's not satisfactory, no?
So I have
only good wishes for all my colleagues in TMC, Mamata Banerjee. They are free to say whatever they want to say. Well, don't forget that TMC and Mamata Banerjee also walked out of Atal Bihari Vajpayee when Atalji needed her the most. And I was the one who told Mamataji that please come and meet Atalji. I'd fix up an appointment also. But that didn't happen. Whatever Mamataji wanted, Atalji did. But in spite of that, he walked out. He wanted a resignation of George Fernandez. She wanted so many other things. Everything was accepted. But still, so ye nahi hota hai. Ki wholesale mein aap chale jao, to wo daga nahi hota hai. Individual jao, to wo daga hota hai. Today you are fighting against Congress. Tomorrow you join hands with the Congress. To wo daga nahi hota hai. To ye to apne par hai. As long as my conscience is clear, as long as I'm happy with it, I have to look into my own conscience first and then the rest.
Okay. So Dinesh, we spent the last several minutes talking about why you took this dramatic decision of leaving the Trinamool Congress. I want to spend the next few minutes talking about what happens next. Dinesh Trivedi 2.0, the new avatar. The hot money on the street in Parliament and in Kolkata is that over the next 2-3 days, Dinesh Trivedi will be joining the BJP and will now be carrying the saffron flag. Is that deal done?
I have always carried my conscience. And humne jo kaha parliament, actually around people, whether they want to, it came from the core of my heart. And at times, whatever you say, whatever comes from your antakaran, I know these days, if some politicians say that the question is, "Arey Baba, politician ko bhi antakaran hota hai kya?" And I don't blame them for the audience asking that. But the fact of life is, honestly, it just happened today. It was nothing. Everybody was surprised.
You hadn't thought this through. You hadn't planned that you'd do this on the last day of the first part of the budget session. You just stood up and said, "Chalo, ho gaya."
I must tell you, when I was going to parliament, you have your mentors, you have your gurus, and you just check with them. So everybody has, you know, I am a sister of Swami Chinmayananda, of Chinmaya Mission. So I did speak to, you know, that Swami Guru Chinmayananda is not there. So I did speak to Swami Tejumayananda. I said, am I taking the right step? He said, you must go ahead. Whoever I consulted, they say, you must, if you're doing for the country. And for the country, you have to do it. Whatever is good for the country, not what's good for you. Whatever is good for the country, you have to do that. So I have done, and obviously I spoke to my family too. So my conscience is very clear. And before that, let me tell you, all the leaders of TMC who matter, fortunately, I have texted them that this is the condition of the party. No reaction. And I had always told that I will tell Mamataji first, and I had sent her a message that it's enough. I cannot take it anymore. For me, country is bigger than anything else. So I had promised people that she will be the first one to know. Whether she believed it or not, I don't know. But my good wishes will always remain with her. I'll never get personal. Never get personal with anybody. And political life, there is no full stop. One has to keep on going as long as there. So these are all, you know, कहते हैं कि वो ऊपर वाला decide करता है, आपको प्रोत्साहन मिलता है. हमको आज प्रोत्साहन मिला करने का, हमने किया.
So do you?
और हम, can you see on my face? I'm so relieved, so relaxed.
You look like
so
a happy man. You look like a relieved, content, happy man. You've been stuck and suffocated for a while.
I tell you how relieved I am. ये मेरे ऊपर जैसे बोझ आता था कि हम बोल नहीं सकते हैं, किसी का काम नहीं कर सकते हैं, किसी को I can't do anything. तो वो बोझ मेरे सर से आज हट गया. But at the same time, I certainly will wish the entire TMC, ममता जी, everybody good health, good life. But I will fold that hand. Please condemn violence. Don't accept violence. Okay. You are at the helm of affair. Prashasan aapke haath mein hai. Violence dusra bhi karta hai, to usko aap theek karo. Magar Gandhi ji ka naam yadi lete ho, Subhash Chandra Bose, Vivekanand, aur violence, aur ye kadwahat kyon? Gali galoch kyon? Ek baat jo hai, hum log kar sakte hai achhi tarah. Gali galoch mat karo, ye Bengal ka bhala nahi hoga. Aur hamesha bahar wale, andar wale, और पता नहीं गुजरातियों के ऊपर क्या है, गुजराती को रोज गाली देते हैं, नहीं जरूरत है यार. देखो गांधी जी गुजरात के थे, वल्लभ भाई पटेल गुजराती थे, नरसिंह मेहता वैष्णु वजन तो तेने रे कहिए. देन जस्ट बिकॉज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर, ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ गुजरात, तो मैक्सिमम ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ रविन्द्रनाथ टैगोर, शरद चंद्र चट्टोपाध्याय इज डन इन गुजरात. सो डोंट गेट इनटू, इंडिया इज वन. Right from Kashmir, Kanyakumari, Bengal, everybody is. That's why Janagana Mana.
No, so I'm going to ask you a direct question, and I'm hoping you won't duck, dodge, or weave. Would you be fighting the assembly elections on a BJP ticket? Do you now see yourself in a different avatar? Not this Rajya Sabha politician Dinesh Trivedi, but coming back to your roots in Bengal and actually fighting on a BJP ticket in this assembly election?
I mean, very honestly, and I'm not trying to be very modest. You know, in public life, you can do good to people without being an MP or MLA or a minister. If that platform of a minister is there, you can do much, much better, much faster. But Rahul, honestly, today, you know, everything was very sudden for me also. You won't believe it. I, on oath, I'm telling you. When I got up this morning, I had no idea that I'm going to do this in the afternoon. But then, you know, it's like the pressure cooker. I had no idea. But then when I was going to parliament, I talked to my wife and I said, maybe I would like to do this. When I got up in the morning, I had no idea. Then I spoke to my, you know, whoever I consider my mentor. And everybody said, go ahead. Because that thought came in my mind.
No, but surely... you don't believe people are so naive that they'd imagine and accept that you resigned without having a pre-existing arrangement about an induction into the Bharatiya Janata Party already worked out to the last detail.
Dekho, Bharatiya Janata Party, let me tell you, not today. Narendra Bhai has been a friend from 1990 and we still remain friends. If I wanted to join BJP, I would have done in 2014. The doors were always open. They were never closed. Never, ever. So with Amit Bhai, with them, you can discuss, differ, argue. But here, you can't do it. And I used to tell my friends, in TMC also, and I used to tell, with Narendra Bhai, you can discuss, you can argue, you can differ. But here, you can't do that. So, ye jo psychophants hote hai na, wo baat kar dete. So I think country is much bigger. And believe me, whenever I have spoken to Mr. Modi or Amit Bhai, it's only about the country. Nothing ever. Only about India. And even when he was Gujarat Chief Minister, I as a TMC MP, I have gone to him many times. Many, many times. People won't understand. So for BJP, I was not looking for an opening now. It was always there. I could have gone, become a minister, whatever. But then I had formed a party on my own. I didn't want to leave. And Narendra Bhai understands all this thing much, much better. And he also understands the emotions involved. But then he also understands that enough must have been enough. So, Rahul, I'm as close to Mr. Yechury too. You ask him, Biman Bose.
Sir, seedha batao na, aap jalebi bana rahe ho. BJP kab join kar rahe ho aap?
Dekho, I'm BJP. If I'm joining BJP, nobody can stop me, no. And I don't think so. I'll be doing something terribly wrong. No, BJP is a national party. And if they have, I was told that, the big leaders said there is most welcome, I'm grateful. So, there is nothing wrong in joining BJP. There is just nothing wrong. And I'm not going to play hide and seek. But as of this hour at 6:35, I still have to collect my thoughts and understand what it is. And then I'll be free to think about the next step. So, I'm not in a tearing hurry ki sab kuch ho gaya hai aap jao aise nahi hota hamare sab dost hai jab jis din jana hoga I'll go and I have no doubt about it because they have seen me work and they also know ki hamara hum jo karenge koi len den thodi hota hai ki aap humko ye do to hi hum jayenge aisa nahi hota hamare sath to nahi hota jab mamta ji ke sath party banayi thi tab kya tha kuch bhi to nahi tha आगे में संघर्ष था
संघर्ष के सिवा कुछ नहीं इफ आई थिंक ऑफ दिस इज एन आईपीएल
हमने और राहुल आप बताएं
इफ आई थिंक ऑफ दिस इज एन आईपीएल फ्रेंचाइज द बीजेपी इज ऑलरेडी अ स्टार स्टडेड लाइनअप अपार्ट फ्रॉम एवरीवन दे हैव राहुल सिन्हा दिलीप घोष सुवेंदु अधिकारी मुकुल रॉय बाबुल सुप्रिय देयर आर ऑलरेडी सो मेनी बैट्समैन व्हाट वैल्यू डू यू ब्रिंग टू दिस फ्रेंचाइज व्हिच इज बियॉन्ड व्हाट दे ऑलरेडी हैव
No. I mean, you're talking about value to me or to BJP or both?
Both. I'm saying as a political activist, what is the value that you believe you add to the BJP bandwagon?
But that you are concluding, I know you are a great journalist because if I say I bring that value, you will say, oh, you're going to BJP. So I have not even thought about those lines as of now. And you, every party, every individual, if you don't bring value, then nothing happens. So value is brought, it's the people's choice. And every party knows, if I have formed TMC and if we fought, it was not only TMC giving me something, we have given our prime time. So we have worked together. And I remember when we used to go to Nandigram with Mamtaji in the car, the goons used to, I can't even tell you what they used to do, but we have jellified those things. So I think I have no regrets. I was very happy to be a part of that movement. It was important to free Bengal from CPM, but then we followed their model, unfortunately. Okay. We did not do the kind of parivartan, let's say in education. By now you should have had in universities of higher education, you should be competing with all the big ones.
Okay.
Why should Bengali go to Harvard or a Princeton or a London School of Economy? You should have that there. And most, when you go to London School of Economy or Harvard, the professors are from Bengal, from India somewhere, from Rajasthan, from Madhya Pradesh. If we have all the best students are from India, the innovation is done in India.
Okay.
All the Indians, not in India, but Indians are doing there. So Bengal is the best of mind, the best of doctors, the poet, the philosopher, the theater, the cinema. This is Bengal.
Okay.
And I think we need to get Bengal in synergy with the center. And it's enough of fight with the center. It's enough of the victim card. This is the time where we have to say, okay, we join hands with you. It is a federal structure. We are paying you tax. Let's work together. And let me share a secret with you. I had given this proposal to TMC, to my leader, and I had spoken to Narendra Bhai also. Narendra Bhai was ready. He said, ask your sister. And when he came to Calcutta, he said after that, ke didi, aap Bengal sambhalo, humko Delhi sambhalne do. Early in 2014. But we were victims. We always played the victim card.
Okay.
Time has come where there has to be synergy with the center. You can fight their policies or they can fight our policy, it doesn't matter. But as far as the benefits to the people are concerned, whether it's on health, whether it's on Ujjwala, whatever, because that money is your money and you are depriving your people of their money. Okay. So I did not understand these kind of, even Singur, let me share with you. After we came to power, I met with Ratan Tata. He was ready to, so you know, let me not get into the nitty gritty.
You know, when I hear you speak, there's an outpouring of emotion, outpouring of angst, outpouring of pent up frustration, and it's all coming out today. And
frustration, it's because Dinesh Trivedi individual, nothing happens. I wouldn't even have told the world what you are telling you today. The bad part is the people, yeah. You are representing people. Parties will come, parties will go. Why should people be deprived?
Sure, and as you said, your jailification, as you put it, is finally over. There's a new political innings that's starting. You've always been, you know, very outspoken, even if at times sycophants, as you say, have tried to constrain you, leash you, hold you back, speak against you. I hope there are no more dramatic resignations and we wait to see what happens in your new innings. But
I need the support of all your audience who are sitting there, and the kind of messages I have got across the country, so many from outside, telling me you have done the right thing, so I feel happy about it. And I'm sure there are two sides. A lot of people will feel that, oh my God, you shouldn't have done that. That's fine. People should have their opinion, doesn't matter. As long as you think you have done okay and there are no hidden agendas, you're okay. You know, so I need support of all your audience there, and I wish them a very good evening.
And as I said, that we look forward to seeing and tracking how your new innings in your new avatar in a new party takes off from here. There are literally dozens of people who are wanting to speak to you. You know, hugely sought after at this moment after his dramatic resignation in the Rajya Sabha. We wish you all the best.
Now, Rahul, in conclusion, I must tell you that day when Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister and Gulam Nabi Azad, the farewell. I mean, can you imagine? That's India. One corner, Gulam Nabi Azad, the leader of opposition, the Prime Minister of India, both are getting emotional. And nobody knew that this incident ever took place. The entire house, I got emotion that, my God, this is feeling, this is sensitivity. You know, and as long as this sensitivity remains, India is strong. Let us not lose that sensitivity in our zeal of election.
At the India Today conclave, your party colleague-to-be, Babul Supriya, is here. Babulda, do you want to welcome to your fold and welcome to the BJP Dinesh Trivedi ji, who in very dramatic circumstances you fought with each other? Give Babulda a mic and we can have an official welcome to the BJP from Babul Supriya to Dinesh Trivedi. They fought each other, Barakpur, Asansol, on different tickets. Now very soon they'll be on the same ticket. Can we have a mic coming as we get Union Minister Babul Supriya to welcome Dinesh Trivedi to the BJP and invite him and join? Babulda, new batsman coming to pad up along with you?
Well, we'll find out whether he's a, I wouldn't say he's a great batsman, I would say he's an all-rounder. I know he can bowl too. We have faced his bowling. I hope now he's going to get us a few wickets. We need that. And welcome to BJP, Dada. As you know, you and me have had long conversations, but we are all bound by the oaths we have taken by the constitution. So I'll not spell anything out, but I just know that you have sown the seeds of this courage long back, and I'm very happy that it is, the flowers have bloomed in the shape of lotus and nothing else.
Now this is exactly what I was telling, that Babul has been such a great friend of mine, and we have been talking about the country and development of Bengal, and who will believe that it's not today. It's been ongoing thing. If I wanted to join BJP, could have done it much, much, That doesn't mean I'm saying, no, I'm not going to join BJP. No. But your question when you ask, the doors are open always. But whatever is good for the country, and Babul is a great guy. I tell you, he also is as emotional. He's an artist at the end of the day. Yeah.
So, but I don't cry anymore, Dinesh. I don't cry anymore. I want people to cry from the Trinamool Congress in Bengal. So that's exactly what the agenda is. So happy to have you on board. And I said you are an all-rounder. You've got a nice haircut now. So welcome to BJP, and we'll all work together towards achieving this goal in 2021 that Honorable Amit Shah Ji and our Honorable Prime Minister set for ourselves, that to give Bengal a good government, a government which means governance and not, you know, everything else that takes you away from that.
Chalo, aapka welcome bhi ho gaya. Dinesh Trivedi, for joining us.
Babul Dahi, hum yehi kahenge, he's a golden voice, and everybody is fond of his voice. Doesn't matter which party they belong to. Bengal needs to go to 22nd century. Bengal needs to show way to the world, and they will do it. All we require is peace and prosperity.
Okay.
We don't require this. And Babul Supriyo is capable of doing that. And with his team, and whatever I can do, I will always be there.
This is part of the magic of the India Today conclave. On the day that he resigned, he's joining us via a satellite link from Delhi, just hours after his dramatic resignation. And here he is talking to his future party colleague and being welcomed on board even before it officially happens. That's the part of the magic of the India Day conclave, which you've all witnessed play itself out over the last half an hour. Dinesh Trivedi, for joining us. Thank you so much, and we wish you all the very best.
Thank you, Rahul. Thank you to all of your audience. I love them all. Hope to see them physically very soon.
Thank you, Dinesh Trivedi. Thank you very much, sir.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.